We bought more than 500,000 hoverboards in the last 3 months of 2015, and by us, I mean all of you. But fires and explosions are raising causes for concern.
CBS2's Vince Gerasole went into the Northbrook labs of Underwriters Laboratories as their engineers look for answers.
One of the hottest gifts this past holiday season is frequently on fire. To date, 52 cases of hoverboards spontaneously bursting into flames have been reported in 24 states.
We're looking for construction errors mainly.
It's cause for concern for the engineers at Northbrook-based Underwriters Laboratories, who rate product safety worldwide.
As we know, this is a counterfeit hoverboard. It uses a UL mark, and it's never been tested.
You may have just one lithium-ion battery in your cell phone, but hoverboards are powered by as many as 24 bundled together. In UL's battery lab, here's what happened when engineers pierced a single counterfeit battery with a nail.
What you just saw there, that explosion, multiply that by 24 cells that are within a battery pack of a hoverboard.
That's why we're seeing these larger fires, right?
Yes, yes. It's multiplying upon itself.
If a certified battery explodes, the pieces should not become projectiles. In this test, pieces were hurled far beyond the protective screen to an unsafe distance.
If this technology has been around for a while,
yes,
why is it now that we're seeing these issues with these batteries catching fire?
Well, because it's a new application. Here you've got a much bigger package of batteries.
We have to make sure that innovation and safety go hand in hand. With the hoverboards, it got a little ahead of itself.
Take a look one more time now here. This is what happens when a battery gets punctured. Now, to date, not a single manufacturer of hoverboards has come forward for UL certification. And the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission, in an unusual step, is now strongly suggesting that they do so. And it's so hard because they look like so much fun, but there is an inherent danger there.
And the kids love them, but they need to be aware of that picture you just showed.
That's right. If you've got one at home, here's what you should do. You should, first of all, make sure that you don't charge it for a long time unattended. Also, they sell for about $500 to $1,000. If for some chance you only pay $200, you probably have a counterfeit one. Also, if it already has UL on it, none have come forward for testing, so it's probably counterfeit.
Bogus.
Good information. Thank you, Vince.
That's great advice.